In 1849, an enterprising New Yorker named Peter Naylor began selling homes that were cheaper than wood, fireproof, and more comfortable than a tent. These homes could be built in a day and were targeted to ambitious treasure hunters headed to California for the gold rush. Naylor used an early version of cold form steel on the roofs he designed for buildings in New York City, and his 20 by 15 foot homes used the same cold form members in these easy assemble homes out west. 75 years later, the Virginia Baptist Hospital was erected using back-to-back cold-form steel channels in its flooring system. 80 years after the building opened, engineers gave the innovative flooring system a hard look during hospital renovations. To their surprise, the steel framing members from the Roaring Twenties were still supporting loads. More than 2 million visitors to Chicago's Century of Progress Exposition in 1933 toured a home of the future made entirely with cold-form steel framing. Architect Howard T. Fisher designed the house after spending years researching how cold-form steel could be used in rail cars. Fisher founded his own company, General Homes, Inc., hoping to do for prefab steel-framed homes what Henry Ford had done for the automobile. In 1939, the American Iron and Steel Institute sponsored a research project at Cornell University led by George Winter to develop a standard set of specifications for cold-form steel. Now known as the father of cold-form steel, Winter published four reports from 1941 through 1946 that laid the groundwork for the use of cold-form steel in construction. In the waning days of World War II, Carl Strandlin founded a company that would build permanent, affordable housing for the servicemen coming home. Lestron Homes manufactured ranch homes made entirely from steel. The company secured $33 million in federal loans and leased an aircraft hangar in Ohio to handle the 25,000 orders received. Lestron delivered fewer than 2,500 homes before going out of business. But the few homes that remain have a loyal cult fan base striving to preserve as many as they can. The next major advance in cold form happened not on a job site, but on a computer. More than 150 years after Peter Naylor advertised cold-form buildings in the paper, companies like Act Building Systems introduced software that enables dealers and clients to design cold-form buildings using a 3D graphical interface. Thousands of clients across Australia and the United States use Act Dimensions to design their dream buildings every year. Easy to design, easy to assemble, building with cold-form has never been easier.